It is a heavyweight collision between Cain Velasquez and AJ Anthony Joshua. All right, here he is, Anthony Joshua. This man needs no introduction in Germany and really across the United Kingdom, where he has done crowds nearing 100,000 people. And a lot of people think tonight in the UFC, it's that big show, big stage experience that could pay dividends for Anthony Joshua. And if it's not that, it'll probably be his pure boxing skills that figure to be as good, if not better, than any man's in this heavyweight division. Your teammate, the former UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Cain Velasquez. And a lot of people ask what could have been had he been able to stay healthy. No denying his status, though, as one of the best heavyweights we've ever seen.
It's unbelievable that you consider him one of the greatest of all time, even though he's missed about 4 years due to injury. But when you look back to the Junior Dos Santos trilogy, getting knocked out in the first round, losing his heavyweight championship, to dominating him over the course of 10 rounds, is unreal to watch. The cardio, the pace, the pressure, the crispness, the tightness, and the accuracy that Cain possesses in his striking was truly amazing. No wasted energy. The Antonio Rodrigo fight, the Nogueira fight, was truly a masterclass in striking.
Yes.
With Cain finishing them in one round.
Our tale of the tape for this heavyweight fight. So these fighters relatively close in age, just a year apart. Some differences in height and reach. All right, now for the particulars inside the octagon of Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a boxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 6'7" tall, weighing in at 237 pounds. Fighting out of London, England, Anthony Joshua. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a wrestler, holding a professional record of 14 wins, 3 losses. He stands 6'1" tall, weighing in at 240 pounds. Fighting out of San Jose, California. Ladies and gentlemen, he is a former UFC heavyweight champion. And when the action begins, a referee in charge, Eve Levine.
The veteran Eve Levine draws the assignment here.
Ready?
All right, so here we go with round one, and when you have what looks like a classic matchup of striker versus grappler, it doesn't always play out that way, but given what these fighters said to us on Thursday, the game plans seem pretty clear.
They're very clear game plans, but which one of them is able to implement the game plan most effectively? The grappler will try to get forward, get close, try to secure takedowns. He's even willing to pull guard to make sure that he is in the grappling situation. The striker needs to stay at space. The striker needs to maintain distance and fight behind that beautiful jab he possesses.
Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just staying busy for the sake of staying busy. These strikes are doing damage.
Oh, yeah, no pity pat to this guy. This guy's trying to land, and he's trying to land effective strikes.
Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Velasquez is right back to the full mount. Oh, big combination of ground and pound strikes here, DC. This could be the beginning of the end.
I mean, you gotta be very careful when you take these big ground and pound strikes. You need a controlled posture on the bottom, and if you're the guy that's looking to finish, continue to gain posture and rain down big strikes on your opponent.
Oh, nice combination of strikes here from the top, standing over his opponent. I don't like Muhammad Ali over Sonny Liston.
Oh, that is a good reference. If you're standing and your opponent's on the ground, you're doing really good work.
Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
Back mount now. He's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
Outstanding ground and pound here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every single one of them count. He is not pity patting. He's not touching. Every punch that lands, he wants you to feel it.
A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Trying to isolate an arm, DC.
He needs to move his hips back to cover. He cannot allow him on that angle. He's going to tag off ball here.
Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. How about this fight, folks? You see, he was nearly caught in a submission there right at the end of the round. Saved by the bell. So back to the stool. Mentally probably not in a great place here. We'll see if he can recover and get himself back into this fight. All right, a lot of highlights from which to choose over those previous 5 minutes, DC. A lot of good work on the ground.
You knew, John, going into the fight, that if he was able to get this fight to the floor, he would have the most success. And you saw it in that exchange. He was able to get posture, land some really good ground and pound as the round came to an end.
All right, DC, here we go with our next round. And how about the ground and pound skills in the previous round? His opponent better make some adjustments or mom's not going to recognize him.
You're funny. He's got no action to change this because this guy on top is so good with his pressure. He's not even controlling your body with his hand. That's the detail that everybody's missing. He's sitting in the half guard, and his bottom half is securing his opponent. So his top half is moving. It's adjusting. He's posting his hand on his face, dropping elbows. When he's able to pull back, he's throwing his punches. There is a real intelligence in his approach to his ground and pound. It is truly, truly great to watch. It is unbelievable to watch a guy so skilled in such an important area of fighting.
Pretty good ground and pound by him here. He told us on Thursday he needed to be more effective in these situations. Certainly effective tonight.
Many people have gone away from this style of fighting. This man has embraced it, and you are seeing why. He's one of the best that we've seen do it in a long time.
While working pretty effectively from the top here, nice ground and pound by Velasquez.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
That is it! Oh, and there comes the stoppage!
Goodness, what a fight.
Yeah, that was just a gorgeous shot to end the fight right there. I'm not even sure the opponent really saw it coming. So back to the drawing board for him. But for the winner, this is certainly exactly what he was looking for here tonight. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 20 seconds of round number 2. Declare the winner by knockout, Kane Velasquez!
All right, so there he is, the man of the hour. What a massive knockout for him to get this win in style tonight.
He did everything he needed to do to find the knockout. Now he can celebrate with his family and friends as they earn this spectacular victory.